Hi everyone, this is Maverick Pua, the chemistry guru. Now in this video, we want to go through drawing the energy cycle involving enthalpy change of combustion. Alright, let's look at this example here. If I want to determine the enthalpy change of formation of propanol, the molecular formula is given as C3H8O given the following enthalpy change of combustion of the following terms. We are given enthalpy change of combustion of propanol, enthalpy change of combustion of graphite carbon, enthalpy change of combustion of hydrogen. So how will we draw an energy cycle to solve for the enthalpy change of formation of propanol? Of course, the first thing we need to do is we need to be familiar with all the enthalpy change terms. So enthalpy change of formation will be the energy change when one mole of compound is formed from elements in a standard state, while enthalpy change of combustion will be the energy change involved when one mole of substance is burned in excess oxygen to give whatever products based on the substance that we are reacting with oxygen. So let's try to write out the equation involving enthalpy change of formation of propanol first. As mentioned, formation of propanol is form one mole of compound from elements in a standard state. So this will be the reaction. I am forming C3H8O in the liquid state, one mole of propanol. So for elements, I have carbon, graphite. So carbon, I have hydrogen, so I need H2 gas, and I have oxygen, so I will need O2 gas. Enthalpy change of formation is with respect to per mole of propanol, so therefore the coefficient for this has to be 1. So based on this as coefficient 1, I have to balance this equation. So I need 3 carbon, so I have 3 carbons here. I need 8 hydrogen, so I need 4 H2, 1 oxygen, so I need half O2 gas. So this equation will represent the enthalpy change of formation of propanol. So therefore, on this arrow here, I can put down the enthalpy change of formation of propanol. So the equation is done. Then the next thing is we try to make use of the rest of these enthalpy change terms. Now we notice enthalpy change of combustion of propanol. Burning C3H8O, the product will be CO2 and water. Burning carbon will give me CO2. Burning hydrogen will give me water. So basically, at this bottom portion here, I'll have carbon dioxide and water because all of them will undergo combustion to give me the same products. So at this bottom here, I can put down this big box, and inside this big box will be carbon dioxide and water. So I can put down CO2, gas, and water in the liquid state. So the products will be here. The next thing we have to do is we have to do balancing. Now, balancing wise, you notice the left hand side and the right hand side is balanced. Now, what I need to do is I need to balance this box at the bottom. So I will either balance the left hand side and the bottom or the right hand side and the bottom. I only need to balance one side. So usually one side is easier to balance than the other side. So this side here, balancing right hand side to CO2 and water, it is easier because it involves the combustion of only one compound, which is C3H8O. If I balance the left hand side, so I'll have to consider the combustion of carbon, which we will need some oxygen. Then I need to consider the combustion of hydrogen, which also requires some oxygen. Then those two moles of oxygen, I will have to add them together. So because it involves the combustion of two things, it's a little bit more troublesome. So this portion here or this side here is easier to balance. So I'll do that here. So I need 3 carbon. So therefore I will have 3 carbon dioxide, 8 hydrogen, so I need 4 water. Now, number of oxygen in this case, if I look at it, I have 6 oxygen here plus 4 oxygen. So altogether, I have 10 oxygen. So this side here must also have 10 oxygen. I actually already have 1 oxygen here in the compound. So therefore, I will need 9 more oxygen. Now, what we can do is I can add oxygen to force out this reaction. So basically, what I can do is I can add 9 oxygen or 9 over 2 oxygen gas to force out this reaction so that I can make use of the enthalpy change of combustion, which is this value minus 2010. Once I add 9 over 2 O2 here, then oxygen will already be balanced. Then this reaction here will be combustion of propanol. So before we do that, you notice now this side is balanced, the right hand side and the bottom side is balanced, but left hand side and right hand side is no longer balanced because I've added 9 over 2 O2 on the right hand side. So therefore, left hand side and right hand side is no longer balanced. So what we have to do is I have to add the same amount of oxygen on the left hand side to keep the equation balanced. So I need this 9 over 2 O2 gas on this left-hand side so that the equation remains balanced. Some tutors, what they will do is the oxygen, they put it on the arrow. But personally, what I prefer to do is I like to put the oxygen together with the reactants because it is more instinctive. We know that if I add oxygen on one side of the equation, in order for me to keep the equation balanced, I need to add the same amount of oxygen on the opposite side of the equation so that the equation continues to be balanced. So I think it's a lot more straightforward. It's easier for us to apply this idea. So now the equation is balanced. Once I've added this 9 over 2O2 here, then the left-hand side and right-hand side is balanced. And this left-hand side and the bottom will also be balanced. We no longer need to balance oxygen. So we can move on to drawing the arrows and quantifying enthalpy change of combustion. As mentioned, this is combustion of propanol. Enthalpy change involved is -2010, so I can put it in. -2010 kilojoule per mole. Now, how about this arrow here? Carbon to carbon dioxide. Now, what we have in this case is combustion of carbon is -394. So I can put this -394 here. But remember, combustion is with respect to per mole of carbon that we are combusting. So in this case, how many moles of carbon do we have? We have 3 moles of carbon. So I need to modify this coefficient. I have to multiply this by 3 times because the enthalpy change of combustion is with respect to per mole of substance that we're burning. If this is coefficient 3, enthalpy change of combustion has to be coefficient 3. So this arrow settled. Next, the combustion of hydrogen to give water. Now, combustion of hydrogen to give water, enthalpy change is here, -286. So I can put this -286. As mentioned, combustion is with respect to per mole of substance that we are burning. I'm burning 4 moles of hydrogen, so therefore I need to modify this by 4 times. The coefficient for H2 is 4. Enthalpy change of combustion for H2 has to be 4. Alright, now that we have gotten the energy cycle, so the next thing is to apply Hess's law. So the clockwise cycle is here. So what I use is the sum of all the total clockwise is equal to sum of counterclockwise arrow. So if I look at the direction of all these arrows, enthalpy change of formation is a clockwise arrow. -2010, this is a clockwise arrow. This value here is a counterclockwise arrow. This is counterclockwise. This arrow here is also a counterclockwise arrow. So what we have is fairly straightforward. Enthalpy change of formation and this arrow is equal to the rest of the other two. So I can work this out, no problem. Enthalpy change of formation -2010 is equal to this value here, -394 times 3, and this value here, -286 times 4. So I can bring this -2010 over to the right hand side, and I can solve for enthalpy change of formation. Enthalpy change of formation will work out to be -316 kilojoule per mole. Now, one more thing to add. Actually, there's a formula method that we can use. If all the enthalpy change terms given inside the question is involving combustion. So some of us might have this preference to use the formula method when we encounter questions like this, which are fairly straightforward. So my suggestion is we try not to be over reliant on the formula method, because formula method only works when all the enthalpy change terms are combustion. There's also another formula involving enthalpy change terms for formation, but these two formulas are only for very simple energy cycles involving all the enthalpy change terms are combustion and all the enthalpy change terms are formation. So when we do slightly more advanced questions, we have to draw the energy cycle to work out the unknown enthalpy change term. So what we have to do is we have to make use of very simple cycles like this, enthalpy change of combustion, as well as enthalpy change of formation terms, to practice and get a hang of drawing energy cycle. So if we don't know how to draw energy cycles involving simple questions, then when we do complicated questions, definitely we will run into problems. So if you are facing difficulties in drawing energy cycle, maybe what you can ask yourself is two things. First thing is, are you familiar with the definition of all the enthalpy change terms that is in syllabus? Second thing is, do you have the tendency to avoid drawing energy cycle? Because for simple questions, you always try to do by formula method. If you have this tendency, then that is the issue. It is not because drawing energy cycle is really difficult. It's because we don't practice using simple examples. Alright, so if you have learned something useful in this video, please give me the thumbs up and subscribe to my YouTube channel for more weekly video lessons. That's all for now. Thanks for watching.